Okay guys, the show's about to start guys, so get ready for some really amazing bird life. Don't forget, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, put your comments down below, tell us what you'd like to see. Enjoy the free flight bird show guys. Enjoy.
But also talk about some ways that we can all help to protect our birds for our future generations to appreciate and enjoy. It is believed that the first of our modern birds evolved around 100 million years ago. Now in this time, birds have had the ability to adapt to a whole range of different environments and conditions, so much so that they can be found on every continent of this world. But I'll tell you what, since we humans have colonized the planet, we've changed many of the natural environments and conditions which birds rely on. Take the black cockatoo for example.
Now here up on stage with us, we have two different species of black cockatoo. And with Tennille, she's got our red-tailed black cockatoos. We've got the lovely phoenix displaying that vibrant red tail flying over your head. And Barb, our 30-year-old red-tailed black cockatoo there as well. With me, I have a yellow-tailed black cockatoo. She's a juvenile, her name is Licorice. And Licorice has jumped to head on out and meet one of you today in the show. And I actually think she's chosen someone. Lady there in the yellow top, seeing as you have the same colourings on, would you like to stand up for us? Stay exactly where you are and just extend your arm out to the side for me nice and flat. And you are going to get a nice close encounter with Licorice here today. Now these two are two of six different species of black cockatoo that live here in Australia. Thank you so much. But unfortunately, they're all listed as vulnerable, threatened or endangered, mainly because of loss of habitat. But it's not bad news for all our birds here in Australia.
We have bird species that are actually doing considerably well. Now I'm not sure if you've noticed Barry or Larry, the Australian white ibis, knowing that where there's France, there's probably an easy chance of food. Noisy miners, magpie larks, kookaburras as well, that like to join the show. Regardless of what side of the scales they sit on today, doing well or doing not, we'll simply hate to see any of these birds fade away. But I'll tell you what, we do have kookaburra up here, who's a very important kookaburra, and that's to head out the back and get the rest of the birds ready to fly. So what do you reckon, kookaburra? Thank you. Like I said, we would hate to see any of these magnificent species fade away to the point of extinction. Luckily, we are still known here in Australia as the land of the parrot, which means you see lots of our colourful feathered friends out and about during the day, probably foraging for food, considering that 75% of their daily activity. For the rest of that, they're probably looking for old growth forests. Tree hollows like that one here on stage on my left-hand side would actually take hundreds of years to form. That is exactly what parrot species rely on for that reproduction and survival. But as you can see, it's not just parrot species that utilize old growth forests. It also makes home to many of our nocturnal predators, just like this beautiful mast owl. And this individual's name is Gorilla. Now have a look at the amazing features on this bird. That arch-shaped disc-like face, which isn't there just for looks, it's used like a satellite dish. The stiff feathers around the frame of that face actually collect and channel sound inwards towards the ears. The ears on this bird are actually lopsided, meaning that they can triangulate sound. Exactly what she's doing right now. Honing in, moving her heads back and forth. But I'll tell you what, when they find and pinpoint the exact location of any potential prey item, that's when they ambush it. Now they have a key adaptation which makes them such a great ambush bird, and that is the fact that they have frayed feather edges. Those frayed feathers on their edges, or the frayed edges on their feathers, is what cut that air column so gently it creates no sound whatsoever. Which means no prey item is going to hear this formidable predator in the darkness of night. And as you can see, they'll subdue that prey item with those extremely large talons in comparison to their body size. So what you're looking at is one giant cotton ball that flies through the air at night time. Looks like she's gonna fall off that pastel tissue. But I'll tell you what, they actually have a cousin, the barn owl. Now the barn owl is a relative and it's much smaller in comparison. The barn owl is quite successful since the introduction of Europeans to this land because we're able to provide an artificial housing infrastructure. So clock towers, elevated warehouses, churches, and of course where they get their name, barns. Now the barn owl is so successful
is so useful in our Australian environment. They say a breeding pair of barn owls can catch and consume up to 2,000 rats and mice every single year. So what you're looking at right now is the cutest and fluffiest little rat trap in the Australian environment, and one that is very beneficial to us to eat. And I'll tell you what, if you want to encourage them into your backyard, simply put up nest boxes like the one on my right hand side as a substitute. I hear that vocalized thought, or you might actually, he's a male. It's only the male bark now, so it's screamed by the woman. Like that. Check out some of the amazing features on this bird. Like their big, bright yellow eyes, telling us that barking owls are a particular species of bird. That means that they mainly like to do their hunting at dawn and also at dusk. But also check out this bird's talents in comparison to their body size. They can take down animals twice their own size. So something easy like a self-progressive cockatoo or a brush-tailed possum that will easily be on the menu for this bird.
That's a kite, guys. That's a bird called a kite.
They're very fast.
Yeah.
That bird is so amazing.
Yeah.
How magnificent black kites! Speaking of magnificent though, this next bird considers itself to be quite magnificent. Just like us, or humans, he loves the oceans and waterways. His name is Marlin and he is an Australian pelican! Well, as he looks, but he lacks in manners, so please excuse him. Now the Australian pelican can live in some pretty extreme weather conditions found all around Australia. One thing the pelicans do is they rely on the flooding rains to trickle and fill the floodplains with salt lakes. As soon as water is added to the bed of the salt pan, such as Lake Eyre, little eggs of fish and crustacea hatch out. Even after laying dormant for up to 10 years, then creating an abundance of food. You get that one? So what happens is to reproduce, pelicans will migrate thousands of kilometres from where they are to these ancestral breeding grounds. They reproduce, they raise their young, and once that's all done, they shake the tail feather home. Wave goodbye. chip. All right, awesome. Come over here, sweetheart. Have a seat on that chair for me, darling. All right, you're going to feed this next bird, okay? It's really simple stuff. We need to see if this bird's ready for the show. So pop out your left hand for me. Which hand's your left hand? I'll give you a clue. Well done. You got it. So here we go. Here's your food. It's not for you. It's for the bird, okay? So when the bird comes up to you, all you have to do is feed it, Boston. You feeling confident with that? Yeah, you good? What if I tell you it's a really big bird? You still good? Good for it. All right, ready? Good luck, Boston. I'm going to be over here. It's nice and safe. Okay. Now, just, Boston, make sure you feed him. That's your one job. It is time to release Titan. Excellent, Boston. I'll tell you what, you're one step away from being a bird keeper. Just do what I do, ready? Spread your feet. That's it, slap your hands together, grab together really fast, and just wipe your dirty hands all over your clothes. This is a bird keeper, that's for sure. Hang on, Boston. I'll give you some sanitizer so your teachers don't kill me. Here we go. Where is it? Is it coming out? To the people at the back who gave me this. Hang on, we're gonna check. We're gonna do this. You got it. All right, Boston. Let's give him a big round of applause. You can go have a seat now, sweetheart. Safe and sound. All in one piece. Whoop, that's nearly. Excellent. All right, but on a serious note, throughout history across the earth, humans have always had a love-hate relationship with large predators. Now, unfortunately, like every other large predator around the world, the largest of our raptors has felt nothing but unwanted fear and hatred from humans. This bird has struggled for survival since the introduction of Currumbins to this land. In 50 years, 1 million wedge-tailed eagles were wiped out and almost to the point of extinction. Now, to put this into perspective, if we laid this species from wingtip, deceased species that we trapped, shot, or even poisoned, they would reach all the way across Australia. The reason for that is the government put a bounty on their head thinking that they were evil livestock killers. And it turns out we were actually wrong. The wedge-tailed eagle are actually quite lazy hunters out of the raptorial species. If they can, they prefer to take down the sick, the dying, but most of all, consume the dead. So carrion feeders, very similar to a vulture. We did research and we discovered that the wedge-tailed eagle has a very simple attitude. It's why bother hunt when you can have a truck do all the work for you. They also made an amazing comeback because of the introduction of the feral animals that have been in this country. The fox, the cat, the rabbit, the hare. And if we all do, then hopefully as a result of this, we will see less animals come to our wildlife hospital every single year. Now, for those who don't know, our wildlife hospital received over 10,000 animals last year that needed treatment and rehabilitation to be released back into the wild. That's sad. The positive thing is every one of you, by walking through our doorstep, you have contributed to the daily care of these animals.
Hey guys, hope you're enjoying everything so far. We're on our way actually to the Mini Monsters Show. Don't ask me what it is, guys, but it's got something to do with an animal. So, the Mini Monsters Show, guys. And we're going to go and check out what it actually is. So stay watching, guys. Don't forget, hit the subscribe, click the like, tell us what you want to see below, guys. Put in the comments. Pop your comments down. Hey, guys, we're about to go on the train. It's going to be here in about 5 minutes' time, guys. That's right, the train's nearly going to come right now, guys. So we're going to jump on the train and I'm going to show you around a bit. And then I think it's probably getting close to getting something to eat, guys. So come and join us for something to eat.
And then we're going to feed the kangaroos.
And then we're going to feed some kangaroos, guys, and catch some of the other shows happening as well. It's a full day here, guys. So don't forget, if you're in Australia and you're up in the Gold Coast, come down to Currumbin Wildlife Sanctuary. It's an amazing, amazing experience for the family, for the kids. It's educational, it's everything. So, guys, don't forget, come down. Has a bird come to say hello to us, guys? Hello. Hello, little bird. See? He's come to say hello to us, guys. He's from the minor family, guys. That bird, he's from the minor family. So, yeah, guys, enjoy. Enjoy, enjoy, guys. This is a full day. We're here for a full day.
We're going to be
fed
down. Okay, guys, train's on its way here. It's about to come. I'll show you the train as it comes. There it comes, guys. The train's coming down the track, guys. This is the one we're going to get on. This is the one we're going to get on, guys. Here comes the train. Let's get on the train, guys. Have a bit of a look around, okay? Stay with us. Hey, Francesco, where are we?
Train.
Yeah, guys, we're in the train. We're going to have a bit of a train ride. We're going to show you a bit around, guys. So join us. Hi, mommy. So it was a selfie time, guys.
So did that part of the month that you're on.
Okay, guys, we're about to go now.
Train is departing, folks.
Wow.
Train is departing. Next stop, Kangaroo Crossing Station.
Wow.
So now, folks, if you've just joined us, welcome. A friendly safety message, one and all. Please, folks, let's keep our hands and feet, all our belongings, inside the train, inside the carriages as we travel.
Here we go, guys. On and on the move.
What's your name?
First place, you just hit me in the head.
Oh, it's you.